golden ale, I believe.
Anyway,
I bottled it last time. One of the friends.
Glasgow is kind of a melting pot of disparate musical ideas that somehow work together.
Ooh, that was good.
Thanks. I used that word last night to describe a band, so I just used it now.
Okay, this first song is from our first record. Features Kevin Brawley here on the clarinet, ladies and germs. Yeah. One hand stuck fast to the side of your face. Your backside in the air, mouth half open, but still filled with grace. As your skin turns the color of a violent golden sky, and it cuts me up when we fight and go to bed facing opposite sides. Split screen.
The remnants of a flapjack. I like it. You know, one tiny little bit of a drum beat or a couple of chords could be a little tune, and then we kind of just like play it and play it and play it all the time and kind of take it in different directions, add loads of stuff on top, and kind of slowly, laboriously sculpt a kind of structure and a song out of it, really. Yeah, but it all stems from kind of tiny little bits with us, anyway. Two records that I listened to loads during the writing of our most recent album would have been the Local Natives' second record, and also the National, pretty much all their albums, really. It's nice when you hear an influence, an individual musician or a band's whole sound, that you can kind of pick out the bits that they've taken from other places and hopefully made something kind of new and original with it. We did a project a year or two ago for the Glasgow Film Festival, which was, I think it's itself 10 years old, and we had been living in Glasgow for 10 years, so we wrote new music to 10 short films that we gathered from various filmmakers and wrote all these brand new pieces of music. So that was a really good experience. So I think going forward we'd love to do that again. And I think the music kind of suits it.
Thanks to Jaw Brew for being here.
not from our sponsors. It's very vice.
Okay, here's a nice little, well, not for me to say, but here's a nice little song from our new record.
Sifted through the library of the last 10 years, and there hasn't, I don't suppose, been a moment we can hold as close as the night that we kicked off our clothes and swam in the salt. I wish a deep and early grave to the collection of moments I caved, whether they were minute or massive waves, as I lay in the bed we made, swallowed whole. Lovely of life sentences, all I wanted was to mention this. You're here in my
didn't really write any music until I moved through to Glasgow, roughly age 18. The members of Admiral Fallow met through kind of studying music together, and kind of carried that on since we finished. Well, if you're sticking to a kind of regular form of writing an album of music, you kind of know what that is, because there's obviously so many records that exist in the world. And of course, when it comes to like scoring for Moving Image, that kind of goes out the window. And
no.
an interesting thing to kind of try and get your head around. I mean, it's such a, it would seem like such a vast undertaking. I've got some kind of solid classics that I go back to and watch quite a lot of things like Lost in Translation, which I for some reason find myself watching every sort of 4 or 5 months. I need to like go back and just watch it again. It's one of these kind of magical movies whereby the kind of I've never been over to anywhere in Asia, so like that is a kind of undiscovered thing for me. It's a great movie, and the soundtrack is actually totally brilliant. Plus Bill Murray's brilliant.
Film and of Paul Thomas Anderson and John Bryan, who produced the soundtrack, along with Amy Mann, singer-songwriter. She wrote a bunch of songs for it, which are all amazing. They're taken from one of her albums. But the music choice on the film is great, as well as a bit of Supertramp. Two Supertramp tunes, which seems like a strange choice, but it's of that time, so it makes sense. But John Bryan's orchestration is pretty amazing. When you're arranging something, you want it to be interesting, you want it to have a lot of layers, and you know, the best music I find is music that you can listen to again and again and find new stuff. And sort of, maybe you might not quite get it at first, but then there's something that sticks in your head that, like, I think I like that, so I'm going to go back to it and find something. And then you just kind of dig a bit deeper and find all these things that you didn't hear the first time around.